moonlight is reflected in the water like a celestial skipping stone. A creature made of plants and trees walks majestically on four legs towards the water. It stares for a few minutes and looks sad. Sap-filled eyes light up as a ripple comes into the water. The tide pushes in and a wet, bloated dead man in a suit washes up on the shore. He is covered in seaweed and barnacles. The sacred creature looks and sighs and walks back into the forest. Willie's dream. Willie is kept awake all night with dreams of tentacles and vines moving in and out of each other like a deranged porno. Did you each want to describe your trip to the council meetings? It's been a while since we've done this.
Yeah, so I'm probably late. Whilst everyone else is, I'm probably sorting out the opening of the Woolworths and then leave a big list for Rob Goblin to sort of go through to try and it's literally the same stuff every day, but if I don't list out for him, he takes that as an excuse not to do it, so I have to do that every day. So I'm probably usually late to these things just because of that. It's never the same list because he always just tears up the list every time. So I have to write out the same list every day. So yeah, that's probably what I'm doing whilst everyone is making their way there. Then I'm rushing at the end, I reckon.
I would have got up, lit every candle in the church, had done confessionals with Agnes, and she turns up every single day and just tells me about her naughty dreams. send her on her way and skip on down. Well, no, walk on politely down into the thing to be there nice and early.
And Alan?
I would have taken the very long drive from one side of the island to the other to attend the council meetings in what some might describe to be a slightly out of date 1900s, villain looking car, which was a gift from definitely my great 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 grandfather, and it's just been in the family for a long time. Don't ask too
much. I feel that you're not allowed to ride cars on the open asylum. So you're a little silly.
All right, fine. I'm
where it's mostly golf. No, you can. You can. I feel it's frowned upon because it's just such a small island. So anyone who does it, I imagine Willie to drive about in the car if he could drive. Alright, should we start the thing? Okay, so you'll sit down, your council, the round table, the council meeting. You see Crinkle Crunkle sat at the top of the table. Mayor Crinkle
Crinkle.
So you walk coming in towards the corner, you can see Agnes in notes ready. And then in the other corner, you see the Hessian man sat down with a bunch of papers. Right, now chaps, Lord Crinkle Crunkle says. I'm called forth the meeting of the town council. Before I start, has anyone got anything they'd like to add to the meeting this week?
I raised something. I raised it with Agnes to send down the those. I'll hold my tongue. Those unsavory folk from the other islands. Remind me the name of the other islands.
Oh, the Conniving Islands.
Conniving Isles have been. They continue to abuse our fishing rights. They separated from us years ago, of course, and yet they still sail over here and use more fish than we... There are fish. They shouldn't be anywhere near our shores. Sorry, it gets me really flustered every time.
You didn't actually send it to me through the right channels. You sent me an email where you should have put it on a spreadsheet. Agnes. So we can't admit this topic.
Agnes, I sent you an email like you asked because you didn't like me just telling you in the confessional booth what you should be doing, so I sent you an email. I don't know what a spreadsheet is, Agnes.
I don't check my emails, so I asked to be on the spreadsheet. It's all just spam, penis enlargers, Amazon orders that I've made. I don't look at it. It's just a sea of spam.
Well, I'm bringing it up now. You can add it to whatever sheets you wish.
Well, it's not in there, so we can't admit that, I'm afraid. so they would get to fish again. Which I agree with you, actually. I agree with you, and I wish it was added, but it's not.
Then why can't we add it?
Do it properly. So, well, you have to take that up with the ways.
You know,
so,
what, yeah, Agnes, maybe you know those sins that we've forgiven this morning. Maybe they're not forgiven. Maybe that's the case.
Lord Crinkle Crunkle hammers his tiny gavel. This is a jury for some reason. And he says, okay, so we've got serious business to be doing. Not that that's not serious, but we do have actual serious business to be doing. The ferries to the island have gone missing. It's just, not just losing tourism, but we're running out of food. Because that's where all our supplies come from. And we've been having to get the supplies from the goblins who have been doing a kind of pirate situation and they're withholding supplies at the moment. So we have to sort that out. Also, a Michelin-star judge, you know, the people that look at restaurants to see whether they're worthy of a Michelin star.
Mm-hmm.
Well, one of them swept up on the beach today.
Oh, good. There's so they that. Need to judge our local pub cuisine, are they?
Oh, he's dead. That's
probably for the best. Yeah. Well.
Uh-huh. I mean, certain he's dead.
Well, yes, yeah, we are certain he's dead.
With a stick, to, you know, just a little bit of life force left, you know, just in case anyone was peckish.
How recently dead? In fact, do we? Is the problem that he's dead, or the problem that we're not going to get a Michelin star?
Well, it's the problem is he's dead, but the bigger problem is that we've got people sweeping up on the island, and the ferries go missing. That's the big problem. But also because he's dead, and also he's bloated, and he's looked like he's been dead for a few weeks.
Beyond my reach, then.
A few weeks.
Is there any connection? Are these connected? The ferries go well. The ferries have gone missing. Not to ignore the Michelin star, but I'm sure the pub can probably do without it. The ferries going missing, like the big boats, huge boats. Yes, just missing.
Yes, it's just been going missing. A Hessian man challenging. Okay, so I generally have a big problem with this. The Hessian tools have gone tits up since our tourists have been disappearing. I spent 100 Hessian bucks putting up posters for a boat trip to see these phallic stones, and the only people that came were the Petersons, so I'd really like you to focus in on this and sort this out.
So the Hessian tours? Remind me, the Hessian tours?
Yeah. I bring people over on ships and give them a tour of the islands.
Of course, yes.
You mean those bloody tourists that have been upsetting my grasslands where my cattle graze?
Yes, those ones. They've been bringing money into the island. And now they're gone. So I'd like you guys to have a look at that, if that's okay. While I've got the floor, I've got a letter for the postman.
Okay, well, we've not seen the postman in Goblin, a year and a half, maybe?
Yeah, I know that, because I've been working for Every doing the deliveries.
Yeah.
Oh, you're why my bloody Amazon parcels don't rock up to the right bloody barn.
No, that's Amazon, that's a separate, they do their own parcels.
Well, they say that they're delivering it through Every, because they don't have delivery drivers on the island. So it's you, you're the reason they get delivered to barn 4 instead of barn 5.
No, they're just saying that. I didn't get any Amazon parcels. I only get Every approved parcels, or Hermes as well. One of these, whatever it is, it's one of them I work for. I can never remember what we've changed the name to. I've got a letter. I don't know. Who should I give it to then?
Well, I know how to read, so me?
I mean, I wouldn't mind. Mine's
Yeah, take a look. I personally am not too worried about. I'm never going to deliver the message to the postman whether he shows up or not. So yeah.
Well, I've been looking for the postman. So.
Well, I was thinking I was going to deliver it to the postman's closest friend, which is obviously Alan here.
Right. Yes. Of course. Yeah. No. I'll take that. I see him all the.
Pass that over to you.
I hate the Hessian man so much.
Brilliant. yeah. That's fine. I'll definitely remember to give the postman the letter.
Well, I mean, you may as well open it because he isn't here, is he? So you may as well have a look.
I'm not really.
I mean, just have a look at him.
Who looked an awful lot like I did. He raised me to not read other people's posts. It's just a bit uncouth, isn't it, really? Maybe...
Well, I don't care. You know, that's up to you, whatever you want to do with it.
I imagine Hesky Man hands over an envelope that's already been opened.
That's been opened, yeah.
I just got looking at this envelope.
There's a bit of hay coming out of it.
It's already been opened. Have you read the letter?
They've not. It's one of those bad envelopes that doesn't stick properly.
It's been opened. It's been opened with a paper cutter.
Letter mites.
Letter mites leave bite marks. It's been cut open with a blade.
Yeah, little tiny red shredder. They only like the crease. They enjoy eating the crease.
Look, the damage has been done. We may as well have a look.
We already know the Hessian man opens all our mail, so why don't we just get on and read this?
Right, Michael.
Yeah, the postman's been missing, so it's probably worth, you know, having a look.
Unfold the letter. What is on this letter? Other than some bizarre symbols.
It says, "Dear postman, you still haven't found the Kraken love. It's been 5 months. I don't think my arsehole can take it much more. Come soon or I will. Old man Draggle."
Wonderful.
Fuck. Good.
I think I've had that for a while. I should have given that. It's just been sitting on the sides.
Do we need to go see Old Man Draggle again about his problems? Because of as unholy as it sounds, this isn't actually a matter for the church. It's more a pharmacist's problem.
So Crinkle Crunkle gets the floor again. Before you decide on what to do, I do have a request for Willy. Now you see, the goblins, they've been withholding supplies from us. Now that's only until they speak with Willy, who apparently has an oath with them that he hasn't gone back on. Do you have any recollection of this, Williams?
I definitely remember this. I'm going to be honest, I've been very busy. would maybe the goblin who's talking to me remember what the oath was right now?
I wasn't involved in that. I'm just saying, they said there's an oath, a favour that you owe them.
You said that I have gone back on, or I haven't gone back.
No, you haven't done a favour for them. You haven't. You owe them a favour.
I need.
To, they would call you upon that one day. Today is that day. They're going to call that favour upon you.
Just did they help? Did they help us in the battle or something? Was that?
Yes, they did. Yeah.
And was it just an open favour? It wasn't anything specific. It was just.
It was nothing I specific. It was just a favour.
That was really dumb of me, wasn't it?
Yeah, that was dumb of you, the Hessian man says to you, even though he caused all of that.
Yeah, okay, well, I should probably see them real quick then. Get that over with, I reckon. T, do you remember what Rob Goblin's, like, sort of standing with the other goblins is? Because obviously he's with me for the minute.
Not very good. I think he tried to become mayor and has upset everyone from it.
Yeah.
Not great.
I'll leave him behind then.
I mean, it'd be useful. Yeah, yeah. But it's good to have a goblin with you when you're gobbling about.
Yeah, mate, yeah. I'll think about it.
He might be able to, give you counsel on stuff going on.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So we've got two missions. So we've got one, what he needs to do. We've got to go see, Old Man Graggle. We've also got to try and sort out the ships, that situation. So I say he wants to go to have a look at Old Man Draggle's situation. I'm guessing that's going to be you, Alan, because that's been bestowed upon you.
Apparently I'm the bloody postman's best bloody friend. It's news to me.
He thought very highly of you.
I bet he fucking did, you Hessian sacked bastard.
So, Crinkle, what am I going to do? I was hoping I'd be able to help out with all of that. No, we're not doing any of this.
I think we've got this. I don't think
we don't need the glorified animated scarecrow to come with us.
Well, I guess if you need to do something, Sam down the pub, he's been complaining about that his Billy Bass is possessed by a spirit.
Ooh.
So I guess you can go have a look at that if you want, if you feel like you want to be busy, Essien man. Yeah, go on and I'll have a look at that. I'm sure that'd be integral to what's going on here.
Unfortunately, probably will.
Yeah, I was about to say, it better not be integral, I bet.
it's definitely going to be very integral. He's definitely going to use this Billy Bass against us in the future.
So, obviously, the choice is to do whatever you want. There's three things that's happening at the moment.
Are we splitting the council, or should we take on one thing at a time?
You do whatever you want. It's sometimes better to have two things going on at once.
Because
there is a time limit and things will happen.
Narratively speaking, it's good to have multiple strains going on.
I apparently owe a bunch of fey creatures a favour, so I should probably deal with that ASAP. I don't want that to be hanging over us, so I'm definitely doing that.
I guess I should try maybe investigate this corpse that's floating up. I'm somewhat of an expert with the dead, though I'm not sure I'll get much sense out of a bloated body.
If you're doing that, that's next to the thirsty ferret. We could team up.
Team up on the Hessian man.
You can have a look at the Billy Bass with me.
I mean, Billy Bass. That would be more my wheelhouse, frankly, a spirit. But I figured they were just giving you busy work, honestly, Hessian man.
No, it's not busy work. Clearly, it's not. Actually, Crinkle Crumple's like, no, do not go with him to see the Billy Bass. No, you've got actual things to look at. You know, well, if you're going to do that while you're out, you may as well look at Chris's bloody cursed pinball machine.
Who's asking me this? Is this...
Crinkle Crunkle.
Are you wanting me to go look at a...
No, he doesn't. He's being sarcastic. He's
right, I don't do sarcasm.
It does feel very odd that the priest is being asked to go and look at all the cursed objects in town.
That is a true thing.
Should I not go do this? That's Crinkle Crinkle. Just tell me. Should I go see this body? Should I go find out and see if I can find your bloody fairies?
Yeah, go on then. That'd be fine. Go have a look.
I'm going to saunter on out.
Oh, I see a man follows you.
Would you leave me alone?
Hey, we've got a team today. We're buddying up.
I mean, as a farmer, I don't quite know how much help I'm going to be for an old man who apparently has a gaping anus and a love for a dragon that needs to be dealt with, but I'm intrigued by the goblin thing, so I might just tag along with Willy and see what's going on with the goblin folk before we deal with.
Well, that's fine. You can do whatever.
The latest time for High Speed 2.
Good idea. Yeah, I'm not really in a hurry for the Kraken stuff, so we can put that off, I reckon.
That doesn't feel plot integral. That feels like a side quest.
Okay.
Old Man Craggle's a champ. He can take it a few more weeks. It's fine.
I've been waiting years.
Well, he can last a little while longer, can't he? He's got that seaweed remedy we gave him last time. I'm sure he'll cope.
Okay, so right, you'll leave. Okay, so what? Okay, we're gonna start. I'm gonna start with the Hessian man and Lewis. Right, so what are you doing then, Lewis?
Well, I assume I know where this body's washed up and it's where the ferries are.
It's next to the Thirsty Ferret.
Next to the Thirsty Ferret, yeah. Can we go see where the body is?
No. Yeah, so you follow up, you see it's been cautioned of.
Do we have a priest
body in the water? Sort of. There's been a lot of Fae are quite anarchist and they sort of try to suppress any police force. There's really only a couple of cops. There's a lot going on. So everything sort of takes a while, prestigiously.
I'll just wander past the barricade, police barricade, to go look at the body. I'm assuming no one's going to try.
Yeah, some man comes after you. He's put a nice long sort of like trench coat on. He's got changed on the way. He's got like a whole kind of Columbo feel going on with him.
See, man. If you do insist on being here, and it appears you do, can you just keep an eye out for any clues I might not spot? So you've got insight into your Hessian realm, perhaps you could...
I can't get into the Hessian realm at the moment.
No, so you're beyond useless. No. Sorry, I'm sure you're...
Why do you think I've been given these tours? Why do you think I've been doing the every pass so I can't get into the Hessian realm?
Well, you've been very helpful, and I apologise for saying you're useless. I'm trying to work on putting people down. So thank you, Hessian man. But if you can keep an eye out for clues, we're going to go have a look at this body and I'm going to see if I can get any information from them.
Okay, so you go to the body. Where do you look on the body?
I'm going to try and raise him, if possible.
Yes, okay.
I'm a little worried he's a bit decayed, so he might be a bit fucking disgusting if he comes back to life.
Can you roll for magic, please? So that's, is it fight, I think it is? Seven.
Not good.
So the eyes open up. There's a slight bit of ghost eyes coming out. And you hear him say... you hear him say...
Put my ear real close to it.
Yeah. Get closer, you sort of whisper him. You ready?
Yeah.
What is it? Says, the calamari is a little dry.
And then he vanishes
back into nothing.
Right. Okay. So either he's concerned about maybe the Kraken or he just had to try some of the calamari served at the Thirsty Ferret. Hessian man, have you tried any of the calamari around here?
Oh, you see, I don't eat that because octopuses are incredibly intelligent creatures and I think it's a little bit wrong to be eating them. I'm not as much as a villain as you, apparently.
I don't eat them either because of their herald of my Saint Tentaculus. So I couldn't comment on if they're dry or not, but...
Not tried them, no. Okay, so it sounds like you've got nothing. Should we go have a look at my thing?
The bass.
Yes. Sounds like the most important thing here, doesn't it, really?
I just want to have a look at the body for a little bit more, Hessian man. Just let me see if I can figure out what killed him. Like, maybe... will the bass thing take long?
No,
we're not letting you set the agenda. Crinkle Crunkle gave me very strict commands not to go near your Billy Bass.
He told me to do it. It's clearly an important
thing. Yeah, for you to do it. But maybe. But it's your important task. I shouldn't intrude upon your important task. If you want to go ahead and go and maybe leave me alone and have a look at the Billy Bass, or if you are going to stick around, then yeah, we need to find where the fairies go from. This is to help your tour guide company, so maybe a little bit of focus, Hessian man.
Well, we could go in there and find out about the calamari.
Let's go in there. You have a look at the bass. I'll ask some questions. Maybe someone was there when he floated ashore.
Yeah, okay, so you go into the thirsty ferret, Hesse Man goes to the bar, gets you a pint each. And you see the Billy Bass up, and it's been cautioned off by police tape. And you go up to Sam down the pub. And Hesse Man says, "So you got little problems with your Billy Bass?" And Sam says, "Yeah, I brought him from the charity shop the other day, and it was meant to play Rock Around the Clock, but it plays Rocket Man. And I've looked at the box, and it only says Rock Around the Clock. And I looked it up, and I rang up the manufacturers, and they said there's no possible way for it to be able to play Rocket Man. So clearly, it must be haunted." I was wondering if you could have a look, find out about it.
Sure. Do you not like Rocket Man?
Well, it's just eerie because it should only play. There's no reason for it to do that. Do you not think that that's a supernatural force that's caused that?
It could well be. Things do get haunted, but it just doesn't seem like a problem. Maybe the spirit just likes Elton John.
Well, I don't know if you could talk to it. You've got like powers, don't you?
Yeah, sure. Let's waste some more of my time today. Let's go have a look at this Billy Bass. I want to just go up and press the button and see what happens.
Okay, you press the button. He goes, "Answer me these riddles free, and a wish will be granted for thee."
Certainly isn't Rocket Man that I remember, but I'm not really into music.
Sam just like, "Oh, it's not done that before. You clearly got Sam. Away with these things."
Ask me your riddle, fish.
Okay, so I'm going to cut there. That's a good cliffhanger there. I'm going to go to Willie and I want to call you Sven, but you're not that. He's close.
Alaric.
Alan. Alaric. Rick. Alaric. Okay. It's a grumble listener. Okay, so it's you two. What's happening then? Where have you gone?
Well, so I think before we head over to the Goblins, we should pop over to Woolworths and grab Rob Goblin, because he might be helpful, he might be a hindrance, but if he wants to help, he might do, so it's worth a shot. Yeah, so I'm going to pop into Woolworths.
Okay, so you see Rob. All right. Wills, what do you want?
Hey, you're right. I need to close up real quick. We need to go see the goblins.
Is this paid? Is this paid work going to see the goblins?
Yes. I'm not a monster. It's paid.
It sounds dangerous. I'd want double time. That's I'm gonna be going down there.
All right, sure. Like you're my only member of staff, anyway. I'm pretty sure my other staff have, like, died or gone missing and stuff.
Okay, so Rob closes up, follows you out. All right, so what's going on? We're going to see the goblins for.
So, you remember that big battle that we had like a year or so ago, and the goblins helped us out with that?
Oh yeah, ask goblins. Were they always helping selflessly?
Well, not entirely. In hindsight, this wasn't the best idea, but at the time we were kind of desperate. I promised them that I'd owe them a favour, and they want to cash that in. So, I think I'm not overly familiar, so I thought, having you along couldn't hurt.
I will warn you though, new mayor of Goblinville, not great. Bit of a dick?
In what way?
A bit of a job's worth.
Oh.
Well, don't like him very much. He's Crinkle Crunkle's second cousin. Did he warn you about him?
Huh?
Did he warn you about really. Him?
No, Crinkle Crunkle didn't warn me. What do I need to look out for with this guy?
Oh, it's just annoying.
Annoying. I think I can handle annoying. I handle annoying quite well.
Yeah, we'll see about that. We'll see what their favourite is. Who's this then?
Oh, good afternoon.
What's this vampire doing with you?
How dare you suggest such a disgraceful thing? I'm not a vampire. I'm a perfectly normal human, thank you very much. I just have a very youthful face. I look an awful lot like my father and my father's father and my father's father, you cheeky bastard. Hello, I'm a Lurik.
Hey, Rob. Should we head down there then? It's a bit sunny today, and then are you
right? That's why I carry an umbrella with me at all times, and I've kind of got like an umbrella Mary Poppins style that I just kind of pull out. just in case, you know, I'm a bit sensitive of the sun, you know how it is. A night out with us farms and whatnot, you know, down with daylight savings and everything else, you know. Night farming is where it's at.
Yeah, I know what you mean. Okay, so we're getting a goblin thing. It's interesting, though. They should be gone by now. Goblin sound. Since the clock's gone, it's just been there, and they've been going a bit mad.
What do you mean gone? What should they be?
The postman, since he's gone, the clock's stuck.
Okay. Huh. Oh, God.
You know about that, don't you, Alan?
Rick? No, well, I do.
Alan, Rick?
About. No, on the other side of the island works differently over there.
There's a clock. A postman. He used to have a watch, and it would show him where we are in the world. Oh, it's hard to explain. It's something to do with, like, different times, different beings would come. And he'd have to make sure that it all runs smoothly. But since he's gone, stuck on goblins, it seems. I escaped it. And I was quite happy being one of the few goblins left here. But they've still here now because causing them suffering.
So you're saying the longer they've been here, they've kind of gotten a bit... What? You said mad. What do you mean by that?
Well, they keep trying to send me faxes.
Okay.
Faxes. I don't have a fax machine.
How do you know they keep trying to send them to you then?
Because they keep throwing fax machines in my window.
Okay.
Before about putting one of the fax machines in?
Nah, that's what they want. It'd be endless faxes then, wouldn't it? Constantly going off.
That's got to be better than the fax machines going through the window, though.
Well, that's alright. It's not my window, is it? It's your window.
Oh, yeah, it's right. Wait, so my... that's what's been happening to my window.
That's why the outside of the shop looks a bit dishevelled, isn't it?
Nah, it's just Willie's thing. He's tired. It never fixes anything. He always tries to get me to fix it. I don't know how to fix anything. Right, should we go to the goblin place then?
Let's head down.
Willie, no offence, but your employee seems a bit shit.
No offence taken. He is shit. Sorry, Rob.
That's just your own. That's vampires. They're always a bit uppity, aren't they?
What the fuck are you saying vampires for, honestly? Just because I'm a little bit pale and I'm averse to the sun.
Alright, So
Willie's definitely oblivious to the whole vampire thing, by the way. There's no way, even with the mention, Willie probably just takes that as Rob being a bit weird, because he will just say shit to
goth
troll
racist.
People. So
goth racist, isn't he?
So walking down the street, there's a man who walks past and he's cut himself shaving, his neck's all bleeding. He's just sort of like, cut myself out of my neck.
Should we just get moving, please? I'm a bit hungry.
Can you roll for threat, I think, would be what that would be.
This isn't going to be good, is it?
Three. Ooh.
Oh,
a feast, a feast you will have. Okay, so now you're gonna have to finish off that bit of blood there. How do you go about it, and how do you conceal yourselves?
Well, first off, I'm gonna be like, say to Willy, I'll be like, "Oh my god, that shelf's gonna fall."
Okay,
yeah, and I,
Willy, can you roll brains, please?
Doesn't seem worth doing with Willy.
Is that not rolling?
Oh, there's a little pop-up that asks about modifiers that pops up after you click the thing.
Yeah, you have to press there. On the main screen after.
Oh, there's nothing popping up.
Okay, Alan Rick,
I can just roll it. I can just roll it.
Okay.
I'm just roll a D8, fuck it.
Alan Rick, can you roll charm?
I can indeed.
God. Two.
Oh,
not convincing.
I rolled an 8, by the way.
Yeah, right.
Okay, so you're there. You're like, there's nothing there. You're not dying. You can tell.
Gonna pull a handkerchief out of my, very suitably fashionable jacket that I'm wearing and just go up to the individual. And I'm very much just like, you've got a bit of a cut on your neck there, sir. Please let me help you. I'll just kind of dab and wipe and rub the neck of the man that's bleeding and then just kind of casually kind of just like huff it like, like a junkie.
Sucking on it.
Sucking on the napkin and huffing it. Rather kind of like...
Why is this worse than you just killing the guy and drinking his blood?
I don't want to be, I don't want to piss Willy off right from the get-go.
What do you think of this, Willy?
I'm trying to think. Am I awkward enough that I would just not mention it? I'd be like...
A bit weird.
Would I just choose to ignore this for now and then keep an eye on it? But I clearly didn't fall for the shelf ring, but I might sort of act like I fell for the shelf ring and be like, yeah. So, what is it with? I can't see it. What is it with these shelves? Said there's something.
The bottom left. Bracket kind of muffled because I'm having a bloody napkin.
Oh yeah, I think I see. You know what? I can deal with that later. Let's go. And I'm just kind of gonna side on him as I kind of brush past to lead the way, but also just want to move on from that situation, I think.
Okay, you make it to Goblin Village with no real other incidents. You can see it's much more industrious than before. There is a huge factory in the water that uses the water windmill, pump out smoke through the big chimneys. And you can look in the background and there's all shanty town tower blocks all going on. It's kind of a goblin industrial revolution's going on there. Rob's like, oh god, this is not good. Look at this. Look what they've done. They've industrialized. This is not good at all.
My great 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 grandfather used to live.
So is there an obvious building or something? I've been here before, pre-industrialization. Is there somewhere that I've either know from previous, maybe there's a town hall type deal, or is there like something that stands out building wise that I should probably, if I wanted to find?
The biggest building there is a giant, like mayor, building. It just says mayor on it, and it's huge. The whole town's built around this building.
Is it like a skyscraper?
It's like a skyscraper, the size of a skyscraper, but it looks like a big
fallacy. Has it got more of a phallic structure to it?
It's got a big. It's a big. Yeah. Big sort of phallic structure with mayor written all the way down there.
I do think that the mayor is overcompensating for something in quite a big way.
All right. Yeah, let's head there.
Right, so we're going to go back to Lewis and the Essien man.
Yes, and the Bass asking me questions.
So what do you say to the Bass?
Well, then just answer your questions. Ask me your questions, fish.
What is wet and doesn't sleep?
What is wet and that could be many things, surely. Just a tiled floor that's got water on it would be wet and doesn't sleep.
Ah, you're a wily one. I'll let you have that. Is not the correct answer. So you get these two, then you may get your wish. What has scales but doesn't weigh?
A lizard? A fish?
Ah, yes, a fish. And your final question. What dies if you take it out of water?
Is the first question the answer the sea? Can I just retroactively answer the first one? Is it the sea?
No. Was a fish.
Do they sleep?
The last one. What?
It was what's wet but doesn't sleep. Fish do sleep.
I don't sleep.
Do you not?
No.
No. Okay, you're not wet either.
Ah, but it's a riddle.
Okay, moving on.
What dies if you take it out of water?
It's just also a fish, isn't it?
Yes! Yes, you are right. You are a clever, wise traveller. And I shall grant you your wish. And there's you as well. Hey, yeah, me. Would you like to answer my riddles and get a wish as well? Yes, I would like a wish, actually. Okay, so here's the first question. What is wet and doesn't sleep? Is it a fish? Yes. Yes, you're very much smarter than the previous person. Here's your second question.
Pretty concerned
about
that.
It has scales, but doesn't weigh. Okay, that's a fish as well. Very good. And your last question, what dies if you take it out of water? Ah, that'd be a fish. Well done, the both of you. Wishes all around. Two wishes to the sack man, and one wish for the human man.
Wait, he gets two wishes.
Ah, he was right with all the questions, whereas you were merely only right with one.
So, let's try and exercise this spirit, shall we?
Do you not want your wishes?
Yes, I want my wish. I don't really want the Hessian man to have wishes. He will wish for evil.
I don't wish for evil. I'm a good guy now. You remember, I'm an every driver. I'm just one of you. You know, I don't have powers anymore. I'm just good.
What are you going to wish for, Hessian man?
World peace.
World peace.
World peace. Smile on every child. That's my two wishes.
Christ, I'm going to have to come up with something a lot less selfish than I was planning. That's
money,
for sure.
Is it money?
No, Hetty man, it wasn't well, money. I wasn't going to ask for world peace, man. No, I was going to ask. It was going to be world peace as well, but you've already done it, so I'm not going to do world peace now. So I'm just going to have to have
that's
a good
answer. First, you can have world peace.
You can do world peace. Well, no,
you can do world peace. I've done a different wish.
You've already done yours, so you've already said what yours will be. So I have to just come up with something else, won't I? Something good. You've already taken care of the two main ones: smiles on children, world peace. What do I want? How's this work, Fish?
Well, you will need to take me to my kingdom.
Is your kingdom the
and
sea?
It is near the sea. If you take me to my kingdom, I can grant you all the one and two wishes that you desire.
Can you grant us to the one and two wishes if we don't take you to your kingdom?
No. My powers only work near sea.
I mean, we're quite near the sea. No, just behind the pub.
Nearer to the sea. This is to land.
I don't want to be tricked by a fish, Hessian man. This fish is bad news. I mean,
I don't think it's bad news. I think I would like to believe. See, the thing is, when I was a villain, I was barely a villain, but I was a little bit of a villain. When I was a villain, I used to sort of think that everybody, was out to get me. But I've since started doing Kundalini yoga, and I've sort of found a belonging within my community, and I've got to look and not live thinking that people are out to get me, because that's not the way to live. That's not the way to live. You've got to hope that people have got good in them. Otherwise, you won't find the good in yourself, priest.
That's very admirable, and it's, you're preaching out of my own book here, but this fish also doesn't understand riddles quite, because the fishes do sleep. So,
I've never seen a fish sleep. He knows better than me. I'm not a fish. Who am I to tell him how his people live?
He is a plastic fish on a wall as well.
Don't we all?
No, Hessian man, I'm saying
we're all just a plastic singing fish on a wall. That's life, isn't it?
No, I'm tempted to try and help him because I was thinking we could wish the fairies back, which would get everything working.
That's a good wish. It's a good wish.
Well, yours were very admirable, though I imagine there might be some problems trying to get world peace, and there'll be something to backfire. But this is what I mean. I don't think he can be trusted. This plastic fish on the wall who is. I could just exercise him and we could be done with this and get on with our actual tasks.
Well, I think. Because he's a fish out of water. And I don't mean that's good. I think he'd rather be in water. I think we should help him.
So we chuck him in the pond and... Sam.
Yeah?
Can we take the fish?
No, that's my fish. That costs me £2.50. Yeah.
£2.50, Christ. That's do you have any change on you, here, man? Could we buy the fish off you?
Well, I've got 10 Hessian bucks.
Sam, would you take...
Oh, that's... No. You take your money in. I won't have any of that fake garbage here. We only have real money. I want to make profit on it because it was petrol there as well, so really I'd want £10.
What, for the fish?
For the fish, yeah, £10.
Oh, I've got around 10.
Well, remember, I could wish you many pounds.
Yeah, but I can't use it selfishly because of Hessian Man's made me feel pretty guilty already about this. I've got a tenner on me. I was going to buy lunch. The charity dish, it was handed around this morning. Everyone was a bit stingy, so I've not got too much cash on me. But I could buy this fish off you for £10 if that's what it takes, Sam.
Oh, yeah, that'd be good. Like £10, that'd be. You got £10 up here.
Really reluctantly reach in my pocket and I get out the loose change that was put into the charity dish along with a note asking for a prayer to be said about their grandkids later and just empty into Sam's hands.
Oh, good to know that I spent their money wisely.
Yeah, well, you wanted us to sort the fish problem. We sorted the fish problem.
I appreciate it.
And they charged me to sort your fish problem. So, you know what? I reckon the calamari here is probably dry, isn't it?
Yeah, you got to pay for your pint as well.
That was Hessian Man bought the pints.
Oh, he brought his own one. I took that, £5.
£5? That's bloody gone up, hasn't it?
Well, yeah, it's the tourists come down. They take their silly money, aren't they? Used to be £10 a pint. Now it's always come here, £10. Londoners, they spend anything on pints.
I take my shoe off where I keep spare change in the bottom of my shoe and pull out a 5 note and give it to him.
Very kind of you.
Not very kind. See you in church on Sunday?
No.
You might want to go. You've got some forgiving to be needed.
We'll see about that. All right, see you later then, Father. See you, man.
I take the fish
Thanks
off the
Thanks for taking my fish.
Do you have any, before I go, do you have any idea about the body that's floated up on shore behind your pub?
Oh, what body?
The body.
I don't get out of here much, no.
The what?
I don't get out of here much, no, I don't know.
It was literally behind your pub. Do you not even look, ever go outside the door?
Too busy. Yeah, I was too busy with my fish.
I look round, the pub's empty, I assume. Just... Okay, fine. We leave, and so Hesley, man, are we gonna just throw this in the fish? Where do you need to go?
Well, take me to the beach. And do you know how to exercise fish? Because if you pull the spirit of me out of it,
and what, you just want your spirit released into the sea?
Yes, and I can pull you with me,
Hesley, man.
Yeah.
I really get a bad vibe from this fish. I don't like to use my powers willy-nilly. I don't...
Yeah, is that true, is it, Father? Because I saw you using your powers to duplicate money the other day.
If I could duplicate money, I'd be a richer man, Hessian man.
I'd say you're good at it.
but this fish wants his soul released from a plastic fish and released into the sea. Do not see how this could go very wrong. You know what the kind of lives we live on this island? You know the kind of shenanigans we get up to? Do you not see it this way?
Most of that was because of me, though, wasn't it? So
at least 40%, but...
You've got to look for the best, because I imagine being a fish spirit stuck inside a plastic fish. What a life that would be. That'd be a terrible life, wouldn't it?
Are you really just a fish trapped inside a plastic body? A fish's soul? Real fish's soul? You're not evil. Can you promise me you're not evil if I do this?
I promise. I'm not an evil fish. I'm a good fish. A magic fish.
Okay. Fish. And when I exercise your fish spirit, how are we going to get our wishes?
I'll put a bubble around you. Fucking Wizard of Oz.
Heretic film. Fine. I'm a little stroppy, and I'm mostly stroppy because a Hessian man keeps showing me up by being a better person. I'm supposed to be the better person, frankly, and I'm fuming. But there's much to the down the hill, past the body, I guess, to the seaside shore.
Yeah.
I get my little Bible out.
Yeah.
I find some passages about fish and possession.
There's loads of them, isn't there? There's loads of passages.
They never stop banging on about fish in this thing. It is just fish left and right. I read one of the many fish passages.
The fish starts to float out of the plastic fish. It's, thank you, Vicar. Not Vicar, priest, all the same, isn't there? And then he flies out, and then you get put into big bubbles, and he dives you into the sea. And then we cut to Willie and Alan Brick. Man.
Okay. Okay, so we're heading to the big
penis building.
Mare building. Yeah, the penis building labeled Mare. Let's go straight there.
Yeah, you walk past plenty of big workhouses with goblin children covered in soot, missing legs. Lots of children and goblins just laying on the street with their limbs cut off, with signs asking for Hessian bucks to get by. Lots of soot everywhere. As As you get closer, you get to the building. That's a clean building. Everything else is covered in shit, but that big phallic building, it's nice. Pristine. Yeah. Lovely, isn't it? It's nicely polished. Yeah. Yeah, so there you go. You're there now. What do you want to do?
So we'll go straight in.
There you walk in. You see a secretary in the little, what are they called, little bits of something.
Is it like
the plastic?
Or is it like
over? It was sunny and now it's overcast.
Is it just like a nice smog in the air that's kind of blocking out?
Smog, yeah.
If I've got me umbrella.
Acid rain.
Oh, okay, so I got me umbrella regardless then.
Yeah, let's go ask about an appointment with the mayor, I suppose.
Oh, he's very busy. He's very busy. If you've got any Hessian books, I might be able to book push you up.
To be honest, this appointment, it isn't something I've requested. I've been summoned here. I owe the mayor a favour, so he might be interested in.
Oh, let's have a look. See his schedule. Oh, he's very busy. He's got fishing. He's got golf. Oh, he's got break dancing. I could probably get you in Thursday at 2. Semi good.
Fishing? I like fishing. Where, do you know good spots to fish here?
Yes, actually. If you go on the... where the fax machine factory is, there's a nice pier there where you can get a lot of nice fish. But I wouldn't go there because the mayor likes to go there. He likes to be left alone.
Yeah. Yeah, obviously, to be fair, I don't like fishing with other people around here. So if I could avoid the mayor when I go, that'd be great. So when's the mayor going to be there so I can avoid...
He's there now, actually. So if you don't go there now, that'd be excellent.
Yeah, I definitely won't go there. You know what? Book me in for Thursday. That's great.
Thursday. What's your name?
Willie.
A last name?
Moore.
Willie. Underline that. 2:00 Thursday. That's that would be good. Okay, so I'll see you later. I'll see you Thursday then.
Right. See you then. I think maybe we go fishing.
I'm up for that. That sounds like a great idea.
All right, let's go. Yeah, then we're gonna head off to the pier.
Okay, so you carry on walking past more and more people with severed arms and legs and heads, holding signs asking for Hessian bucks.
You say severed arms and legs, are they recently severed?
Yeah, factory. We've got bandages with fresh blood out of them and stuff.
Yeah, Willie, I'll catch up. I've seen something interesting in that fax machine factory that needs them. It might be useful as a farming tool. I should be back in a moment.
Yeah, I'm not going to. There's nothing suspicious about that at all. I think that's great. You
fax machine.
You check out the
tractors and fax machines have similar equipment.
That's great. Well, I mean, do that quickly.
Yep.
And then, this is quite important. And then I'll meet you there.
Yeah. No, I'll catch you up.
Okay. So we follow Alaric. Where'd you go? What you doing? What's going on?
Oh, I'm just going to go into the, I'm assuming there's just a gaggle of, mildly brutalized goblins on the side of the street that are all looking a little bit worse for wear. So I'm just going to go to town and just kind of eat a couple of them.
Okay, so you walk across. You see two on the side of the road.
Are they on the side of the road? Is there a side alley that I can possibly just kind of...
There is an alley behind them.
Cool. Can I just... I'm going to try and lure the goblins down to the side. This is just sounding worse and worse. Try and lure the goblin down the side alley. Because that little snack I had in Woolworths wasn't quite enough. It was like, you know, when you like used to go to Woolworths and you used to nick a sweetie from the pick and mix, and then you just wanted more.
Yeah. Than
where I'm at now.
So they look at you, they go, no, sir, are you going to give us some money? Because we're very, very young and poor, and we've got all injured, and we can't work anymore, we're just left here to die.
I do, my wallet is just down that alley there, so
come with me, yeah, thank you for being kind, so I don't get any kindness here.
I will lift you out of the depths of darkness and deliver unto you salvation, to quote my friend.
Follow you there into the dark alley. Yeah, I say, let's have a look. They've got some asking.
I'm just going to grab one by the throat and just kind of.
Oh, yeah, everyone starts to run away.
Brutalize it and just drain it, really.
Yeah. So you're going to go after the other one as well, or you're going to let them.
Oh, no, I just grab both of them. I assume they're
quite. I get a brawl.
What roll?
Just for that second. The first one, you definitely got that second one. I just want to check your. Oh, actually, no, that would be flight, I think, because that's an agility to be able to grab them. Yeah, flight.
Really excited for the whole goblin town to just start pitchforking and chasing Alaric
out.
Two. Oh, good. Two. I'm assuming the little fucker got away.
You fumble. He gets away.
I mean,
but the other one does, and he's been eaten. Is it
No, it's not. It's like, you know, when you have, like, you know, in your head, when you drive past Mackey's and you think, oh, I really want Mackey's. And then you eat Mackey's and you remember that it is just shit.
Yeah.
It's like that. I've just drained a goblin. I've just kind of gone, yeah, that's not great. That's like.
Just as bad as I remember. Yeah, why do I always make this mistake?
I remember the last time I was here, pre-industrial revolution, but my great-grandfather. He used to come down pre-industrial revolution Goblin Town and, you know, eat some of the drunk locals. And frankly, it's not great. It's like, it's lightly from Milch. It's like White Lightning. That's what it's like. It's like drinking a bottle of White Lightning. It is.
Pre-industrial revolution Goblin Town was like last year.
Whereabouts are you? Are you near that dark alley, Willie?
I've very much just gone ahead, so I don't think that. Oh,
is you notice a kid with no arms but two legs runs very quickly past you, and Rob looks. And he goes, oh, he looks scared. I wouldn't want to be whoever pissed him off. Now he goes to the
pit. I should probably call after that goblin, because...
I'm
like, hey, you okay? Do you need help?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, actually, no, I'm all right. And he runs off because he sees, like, they're another humanoids. And he's frightened. He doesn't want to be, you know, fool me once, shame on me. Fool me twice.
Yeah, fair enough. Okay, I'll kind of look at Rob and I'll be like, what do you think we should do here?
Ah, it's all right. Something to do with us. You have to worry about
that. Yeah, but, like, all right. I don't feel good about this, but if he doesn't want help, then I think, you know what, we're probably coming back later anyway.
Maybe. Oh, we'll be fine. We won't get in trouble for anything. Don't worry about it. Just, you know, whatever's happened to him, scare him off.
I'm not worried about us getting in trouble. I'm worried because that goblin seems very scared and is clearly running from something. But we might end up back here soon anyway, so we can always... If there's something here that needs investigating.
Don't worry about him, Willie. He's armless.
Knee slapper.
He's armless, Willie. Don't worry about him.
Come on, Levi.
Don't tell him I made that joke, because I've been in a lot of trouble from whatever it is I'm talking about.
All right. All right, let's go.
So that's something pier.
We need to. Yeah, that's something we need to maybe investigate later. But
get to the pier, you see a goblin fishing.
The goblin what? Ah, fishing. Yeah, I'm just gonna sort of like. Yeah, it's probably not going to occur to me that he's not going to appreciate me being loud. So I'm going to call out to him. Be like, hey, you're the mayor.
Yes, I am the mayor. Yes, I am the mayor. What do you want? Oh, William. Yes, come here.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm a new mayor of Copplingfield. I'm Mayor Jobsworth.
Oh, you're literally called Jobsworth.
Yes, Mayor Jobsworth.
Okay.
I believe there's an oath that you made people some time ago. I've got it written here in this ledger.
Yes, because you... it's been a while, so I'm happy to, like, you know, fulfill my oath, but I may need a bit of refreshing of exactly the details.
I believe there was a... what we've got written in here is it's kind of unclear to what the oath was. It was either a general favour,
right?
But I have a feeling it was a beast you were meant to fight for us. But we've got written in here general favour.
That's the sort of thing I do. So that makes sense. Like, I can fight a thing. That's very much in my wheelhouse.
Oh, that's good. I see, we've got a problem at the moment. We've got... if you notice to your left, you will see a big factory where we make fax machines. It uses the water to generate the electricity to power it. It's out in the sea, and it needs to be there. But unfortunately, there is a creature that comes down and keeps smashing it up every month, the full moon.
Okay.
The moon is big. It seems to come over and smash it up. And I'd like you to smash that up.
I mean, honestly, that sounds pretty straightforward. I was worried it might be a bit more complex than that. But yeah, I mean, I'll need to. Yeah, I didn't. Yeah, I'll need to get my axe. But other than that, yeah. So it comes when there's a full moon. Are we due a full moon or?
Yes, there's one tonight.
All right. Well, that's pretty
coincidental.
A big leafy creature. We're not too sure what it is.
Where did you say? Did you say it was out in the sea? Like how?
No, it comes from the forest through the town, smashes up the factory, and goes towards the sea.
All right, so it's okay. So I don't need to go out into the sea. So I can just wait on the shore, I guess. And...
Yes, you can do that. Rob chimes in. So how much are you going to be paying us then? Jobsworth says nothing. It's a favour that you owe. And I wouldn't be piping up if I were you, Rob Goblin. You know, if we're still feeling the effects of when you were a mayor here. Yeah? Look at all these children with their arms cut off. It's awful what you've done there. At least I only exploited them a little bit. Whereas you've exploited them a lot of bit, which I think is unfair. Jobsworth just ignores him, and he says to you, so what will you be using to fight the beast?
I have a big axe. That's my go-to.
That's not a regulation big axe, though, is it?
I'm not. Am I fighting this thing in the Goblin Town?
Yes, it is technically Goblin, but we have a regulation axe, a bag on, and he gets out his this little bag, and he gets a very small axe, about that big, maybe a hand, like a hand axe that you might use to chop wood. Like it's not a tree, but like a branch. And he hands that to you. This is the regulation axes we have.
You do have regulations here.
That's the regulation, yes, these axes. We don't want anyone to tear.
But you don't appear to have, like, if I'm looking around and I'm looking at the people suffering from your factories, do your regulations not apply? Do you not have regulations for your factories? They seem to just be worked to death.
Yes, we do have regulations. Anyone without arms or legs can't work in the factories. It's a good regulation.
That just seems like a... Like, I feel like if you could have them working, you might want to, like...
No, we're not monsters here, but you need to use this axe. That's what you need to use, this regulation axe. We didn't use that.
What magic has this axe got?
It's got the magic of...
My axe being an axe.
We don't like magic. There's unpredictability of magic. We could definitely not
use fighting a magic creature, right? Like,
no, I don't know. It might be magic, maybe. That's up to magic people to decide. But we know it's just a creature. You've got to use this axe. You'd be able to kill it. You'd be able to kill it with this axe. It's no problems. You're a great beast hunter.
All right.
It's the only shoddy tradesman blames their tools.
All right. Well, I'm going to grab you at, and then I'm not speaking aloud here. I'm speaking like out of character, but I'm definitely grabbing my axe later. I'm not using this axe, but I'm going to take this axe off him and be like, yeah, okay, fine. I can use the regulation axe.
Okay. Right. Okay, so we look up there. So what's going on with Alan?
I've just kind of
Alan Rick
wandering. I've found some.
You got blood all over your face.
I've got my napkin in my pocket, so I kind of just like, you know, wipe the blood away. I look a little bit more rosy cheeked now, less pale, ever so slightly. I mean, you'd barely tell unless you were looking for it, but you know. I also found some ball bearings in case my new friend, in case Willy from the council, wonders what it is that fax machines and tractors have in common mechanically. Just cover all bases, you know.
Okay, so the bear fucks off. Again, it's whatever you want to do now.
Okay, so you're back. You find what you're looking for?
Ah, yes, absolutely, my friend. Yes, no, I got some ball bearings for my tractor's front left wheel. Been a bit squeaky lately. Switch out the ball bearings. Run smooth as clockwork.
I feel like these are quite easy to just buy, aren't they?
Yeah, well, you know what it's like. Every driver, every delivery driver.
I don't know. I don't know if Willy's that smart. I don't know if Willy's that smart. Willy would probably just go, yeah, that sounds right. right, so I'm trying to think. So what are the other things? So
we have to go and talk to... I need to go and talk to Old Man Craggle, and there is a bloated dead corpse on the beach, which is still requiring, as far as we're aware, Reverend Louis is on it, but I don't trust priests and therefore assume he's probably cocked it up.
Okay, what do you want to do first, then? So we've done my thing.
Part of me wants to go and check on the corpse on the beach just because of, you know, the transatlantic tunnel that we're going to have to go and deal with is not at the top of my priority list.
Yeah. I'm happy to put that off. Let's go examine the corpse, I reckon. I don't know what the layout is. Would it be easy for me to stop by my place on the way there? I don't want to take too much of a detour, but if it is on the way, I'd like to stop.
It's not on the way.
Okay. All right, let's go straight to the corpse then.
Do you not have your axe on you?
I've got to go back to my...
Oh, no, I didn't...
Ancient death
metal. I thought about... All right, so... Yeah, I didn't bring my axe because I kind of thought about it, but then I thought, did I want to bring a big like fey killing axe into the goblin town.
Yeah, probably not.
So I didn't basically. But I mean, if we're happy to take our time, I'd like to pop home and get that.
It's early afternoon now. So you're getting to about 2:30, I reckon.
Alright. Yeah, I'm happy to do that. So we'll meet weather corpses, we'll deal with our things, and I don't think we have to litigate that too much. We can probably just jump to whatever time it is.
Alright, we'll go back to Lewis and the Hessian man, who are Bubbles, like the witch, Wizard of Oz. Good witch.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Big bubble, like them. And they're sinking slowly down into the sea with a fish spirit pulling them in. And then they see a big kingdom underneath the sea, all made of coral. But by kingdom, it's more of a tower block. They're not great architects, fish.
It's a very Soviet kind of like, but
yeah, people always think that it'd be like our wondrous architecture, but it's more brutalist architecture. What fish like, which is that people don't realise about them. They love brutalist architecture. So it's all Soviet tower blocks, which they think is beautiful and wondrous, but we don't as much for some reason, more of a preference thing. For Soviet brutalist architecture fans saw kingdom made of coral, like with big castles and stuff, they might go, this is a bit tacky, isn't it? So you go down to the biggest tower block, it takes you in there, and it's all like, there's like a big, when you really go into it, there's like a, you go out of the water, so it's like underwater, but it's not like a cave.
I'm on dry land once I'm in there, yeah.
Yeah, you find yourself like in there, and so you've come out and you're on land now.
Thank you for the lift, I suppose. When do we get our wishes and when can we get out of here?
Oh, you'll get your wishes soon. I just need to take you to help visit our queen.
Help what, sorry?
Visit our queen.
Visit the queen?
Yeah, that's okay.
Sure. No, sure.
I didn't ask to visit any royalty. I'm not very happy about this, but oh, man. So he flies up. It takes you over like loads of steps, loads and loads and loads and loads of steps.
You're still in a bubble?
No, you're walking. And then you get to the top, and then there's a door. And he's like, go through that door and you'll visit the queen. And then you'll get your wishes.
Is the queen giving us the wishes or are you giving us the wishes?
We're both giving you the wishes. It's a joint thing.
Are you coming with us?
I will come after you.
Right, okay. Fine. Let's, the Hessian man... Let's go.
Okay, after you.
After you, Hessian man.
After you.
Fine. Done fighting, I'm just done with it. Yeah. Alright, let's go in. Let's go meet the queen.
You're open the door. What are you doing?
Yeah, I'm pushing open the door.
I open the door and then there's another set of stairs going down. It's very lit.
Well lit, so it's not scary.
Yeah, you can hear a round of applause in the background.
Okay. I emerge down the stairs.
Okay. And then you hear a scouse woman say, what? A she's like a scouse woman, and so, look, there's these. And there's like these seats that you can sit on. And there's an audience in front of you of all different fish spirits and stuff. And different fish and a few goblins. Sure. Like goblin fish.
Okay, yeah.
And she's like, right, love, go on, sit down, take a seat.
Are you the queen?
No, the queen's behind this door. There's a big, like,
bin. I take a seat. Is there two seats? Is it me
there's
and...
Three, there's four seats. There's already one person sat in the seat, and it's an old... got, like, big eyebrows and two teeth.
Big eyebrows.
He's coughing.
Fish, right? Sort of Bruce Forsyth kind of.
No, he sat down. He's more like, he's just like old.
Okay, that's fine. I'll take a seat. We've just been sent by one of your fish spirits. Apparently, the queen's down here to grant us wishes.
Okay, Essie man sits down as well. And get all your wishes will come true. So we're gonna start by just saying, so what would you be your favourite place to go on your first date? Number one, and that's the man in the UK as well. Could go to like a cinema, maybe. Cinema, jelly deals. And then she asked number two, which is you.
Ideal place for a first date.
Yeah.
Probably the what's the tunnels full of skulls in France?
Oh, the catacombs.
Yeah, the catacombs under the church, yeah.
Okay, and then she asks number three. And yes, the man says, well, probably just, you know, in the Hessian realm. I can't really go there at the moment, but that'd be the best place if I could go anywhere. Be there, it's quite a magical place. And then suddenly you hear a loud scream and a giant what are those water spears called? You know what I'm about? Shooting water. Water spears.
Harpoon, yeah.
Just goes straight through that old man's head. And it's like, oh, it looks like we've lost our first contestant. Parity Jelly Deals wasn't a good answer. Okay, now we're going to cut to Willy and Alan Rick.
Well,
I'm in danger.
I guess Jelly Deals wouldn't be a good answer, would it?
I mean, to be fair, when you said it, I was like, that sounds like a really shit first date. I hope they get killed. I'm not going to lie. Like, Lewis's freaking response also sounded kind of crap, I'm gonna, if I'm honest as well.
Lewis doesn't do much dating, I'll be honest, so
I think Lewis is gonna die.
Yeah, this doesn't work out well. I mean, Hessian man's probably got the advantage on Lewis in terms of charisma.
I bet Hessian man can survive harpoon as well.
I know.
It's a straw.
It's just unfair that I'm It's an animated scarecrow.
Alright, so we've done whatever we've got our stuff together. We're just gonna head to the body.
Okay, you get to the body, and when you get there, you see like a little goblin child with two legs. And then kind of the shimmer next to him, like, sort of takes a sort of shape, childlike shape. You can't quite make out where it is. It's sat next to the corpse.
The goblin child killed.
Sorry, 2 seconds.
That's the narrative I'm going to be pushing.
Sorry, can you say that?
Say it again.
Yeah, sorry, can you repeat? I got interrupted there. Sorry, can you repeat?
Okay, so you see the corpse, and next to the corpse, is a goblin child with missing limbs. And then next to it is like a shimmer. The child, like the child's shape shimmer. A ripple.
Oh.
And it's sat there. You can't see his face, either of their faces, sort of dark around it.
Look forward to finding out how much of this would have been different had had Al not murdered a child just a minute ago.
I entered an area where there was fresh blood everywhere. What did you think was going to happen?
Okay, so
Rob looks at the Yiggs. Ah, see, I told you. Whoever did that, they're fucked.
Why are they fucked? Short goblin person.
That's the sisters.
Who are the fucking sisters?
They're not quite goblins. War, vengeful spirits. They sometimes grant.
Unhelpful.
They sometimes grant wishes.
Oh, do they now?
Sometimes.
A lot of wishes going on. Hello. You say sisters. Red sisters. Hello. I'm just going to wave.
You can't see their faces, but there's like a slight wave between the two of them.
I have no idea. Alaric, no idea. Like, the goblin child, it just means nothing to him. He's just looking at this goblin child, assuming the goblin child has killed the corpse.
I'm
intelligent, but I'm bad with faces.
The shimmer next to disappeared, and you hear a sound coming from your stomach, Alaric. Yeah. Would you like me to grant you three wishes?
No, in fact, I feel like I'm going to go and purge in a.
Talk to me these three riddles.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
What should you
do? Can I just go and purge in a bush?
Yeah, you can try.
I'm gonna go and
purge. Can you roll for
roll before purging?
Grit.
Yeah, that's probably a grit. Do you want low rope?
One.
Roll low on the grit or high on the grit?
Low, yeah. You're like really sick.
Good.
It's just red.
Hours, to be fair.
Yeah, but he's still there, just being like, "Oh, is riddles for you? Got three riddles."
All right. Well, the fucking riddles. If the answer to any of these is a fish.
No, not fishes. You're giving it away. Do you want to hear the first riddle?
Go on. What's the first riddle?
First. What is wet and doesn't sleep? What is wet and doesn't sleep? First riddle.
Would it be a fish with narcolepsy, with a fish with insomnia?
That's very good. You're very wise. You there.
See, when you're whispering, you're not picking up on your mic.
Sorry. You, Evermand, would you like a wish as well? Have you got other things to do?
Yeah, I'm not all for wishes, really. I've had bad experiences with wishes.
That's okay. We've got to do just this one. Got second
I'm hearing it coming from his stomach, then.
Yeah, I've got a second riddle for you. What has scales but doesn't weigh?
Is it a fish?
Yes, you're very wise as well as hungry. Very wise and hungry. Here's your third question. What dies if you take it out of water?
Is it a fish?
And the eyes turn red. And it says, Yes, it is a fish, yes. Yes, we'll take you to see the fish. The fish queen.
I'm going to sort of like hold up my hand and be like, hang on a minute. Before you do that, we've got this other business going on.
Can we do the corpse before I get dragged to the fish queen?
So you're hanging around this corpse. Do you know what happens here?
Well, you might be able to find out what happens if you come with us.
For fuck's sake.
I don't want to... real quick.
Willie, do you want to stay with the corpse?
Okay.
And I'll go and endure whatever fish queen related bullshit we've got going on.
I have a feeling maybe not much will get done if I try and stay with the corpse. But before we go, can I have a look at this corpse a little bit? Like, hang on a minute, we're happy to go to see the fish queen or whatever, but like, can we've got this to sort out. Can we have a quick look? I just want to have a quick examine here. See if I can find anything.
You find a wet note in its coat pocket.
Alright, I'll have a look at that then.
It says the calamari is a little dry.
Alright.
Wonderful. A clue.
I think we probably go see this. Real quick, I'm going to go, does this mean anything to you? To the, whatever it was.
To my stomach.
The shimmer.
My talking stomach.
Yeah, to your stomach. Hold it. Does this mean anything to you?
I just wanted to talk about why the tourists are buggering up my grasslands, and somehow I've now got a stomach that's talking.
I think Grant ripped them.
Who's Grant?
Sorry, say that again?
I think Grant ripped them.
Who the bloody hell is Grant?
Who's Grant?
Batman. Wetman. Wetman on the floor.
The dead man.
Yeah. Okay, fair enough. You know what? I think we're going to end up seeing... We're going to have to see the fish queen.
Yep.
I don't like this at all.
Oh, you've got other business to attend to.
Oh, he's not letting you come along.
You've got an oath. We can't break oaths. No, you've got an oath to do.
Oh, all right. Oh, yeah. I wasn't really thinking about time. But yeah, okay, I'll go deal with the... You know what? Have good luck with the fish queen. I'm gonna go fight a leaf ring, I think.
Marvelous.
You know what? It was better when we had like magic and stuff, so that we could communicate and that. But we don't have that right now. So
what's that?
When we had the postman here. We could set up some bullshit, like just say, like, what if we could send a letter and we could communicate with each other and stuff, and it's like we don't have that now.
Maybe you should try your local every driver.
Absolutely. Oh, I don't know where he is.
He's with the fish.
I'm quick looking. Oh no. There wasn't anyone else with him, was there?
Yes.
Was it a priest? Was it a holy man?
It was a holy man.
Great.
Oh god damn it.
Right, I'm
all right, well, you best go.
And you can go and
Kill
the monster.
Sounds like a plan. We'll meet
to help
back
you out
here,
I'm
I
going
guess.
To make it nighttime for you. The moon comes out. That's
fantastic. So, yeah, I'm going to head to the shore then, where I was told this leaf monster will have to go through, so.
Right. So, we get back to the thing going on down in the castle.
Oh, the weird blind date-esque thing going on down in the castle.
You can see, and then in the fourth chair... Bills up with Alan Rick. and you hear the disembodied voice speaking to you. Say, right, now for our next question. What would be your ideal lazy Sunday? To number two.
Which
was you, yes.
That me? Well, Sunday's like the only day I actually have to do any work. So a lazy Sunday, I guess, would be not having to listen to Agnes in the morning. Spend the rest of the day. Oh God, I'm going to die. Spend the rest of the day just down the rectory pub drinking some whiskey and not being harpooned, probably.
No harpoon happens to you, and it moves on to number four. Number four, she wants to ask number four, new person.
So
what's your lazy Sunday?
Lewis has obviously known Alaric for a while, about a year on the town council, and you know, he just assumes, has certain assumptions around him. However, my entire demeanour currently changes into a more aristocratic one, with my accent changes quite significantly. My perfect Sunday would be a long lion before we get up to deal with the assorted strange cows on the farm. We would have a gorgeous rare roast dinner in the afternoon, served with hot apple pie and a large carafe of the finest red wine.
And our queen behind the door likes the sound of that. Sounds very good. Another question for number two. What are you religious? What religious beliefs do you have?
What religious beliefs?
Yeah.
As you can probably see, I'm a from a sect of the Catholic Church, from the Church of Saint Tentaculus.
Oh, Tentaculus!
Saint Tentaculus, yes.
He's
our patron saint. We worship him. We, you know, provide him with our immortal souls and whatnot, and other immortal souls if we happen to come across a bottle of them. Generally keep him appeased and happy.
That sounds very good. Would you just going to take a quick break and just leave you after these advertisement break? And everyone puts a little round of applause and you're left there for a few minutes to sort of talk amongst yourselves. Make a little runner, fetches you all a cup of coffee, which you can't drink because you're tied up.
I didn't know we were tied up before, we just sat in the chair.
Fight up now. Yeah, we can do what's happening.
Al, what is going on? How did you get here? And why do you seem so confident?
I drank something that started talking through my stomach and asked me to do some riddles, and the next thing I know, I'm sat here.
Was the riddles all fish? Was it all fish-related riddles?
Yeah, it was a fish with insomnia, a fish, and then a fish.
Fish for insomnia. Damn, that's a good answer.
Doesn't sleep, does it? So, you know, fish is... Everyone knows fish is bloody well asleep, so it must have had insomnia.
There was a man here before you arrived who got shot in the head with a harpoon.
I can see his corpse is still on the chair next to you.
I don't know how we're supposed to win this. There's three of us. A Hessian man's with me still, unfortunately, yeah, I guess.
Hello,
I a bit stuck on what to do, if I'm honest with you. I don't particularly want to get harpooned.
You're made of straw, you're not going to die.
Yeah, I know, but it's a lot of stitching, isn't it?
Fucking scarecrow.
And I assume only one of us can win this weird, twisted game they've invented.
Do you not think that there's someone that you would prefer?
I'm hoping it's me, but...
Weren't you meant to be helping who is the queen?
I've no bloody clue. There was the fish spirit brought us here instead. I think we've been tricked, like I bloody said would happen.
Wait a minute.
I was
wait a minute. There were three things we had to do at the town council meeting. And we've been avoiding one of them.
We had to find love for the crack and...
yeah. And we've avoided them because no one wanted to deal with the new tunnel for the Orient Express.
We say, and behind that curtain there is a kraken trying to find love.
Yes, and I believe we need to find one, Mr. Craggle. Otherwise, we're going to all end up as a new trans-species centipede tunnel.
Could you not... see, I told you to do this. I never did this letter. Your trusty F driver gave this to you. Could you not convince, maybe... reason with the I'm not getting involved personally because it's not my my fight really. I think you two might be able to sort something out. I'm quite busy, to be honest.
I've never wanted to not- set a scarecrow on fire so much in my life.
This is nothing. you'll definitely want to set a scarecrow on fire more at some point, I'm sure.
You belong in the fields overwatching my corn.
Yeah, I know, here I am in the water. I'd rather be in the field, to be honest with you.
Wow, you were useless in the fields.
So
I just in water.
Did you not go see Old Man Craggle as per your instructions?
No, I didn't want to. I went into the Goblin Realm with Willy.
And where's Willy now?
Back in the Goblin Realm fighting a flower monster, I think. That or a Powerpuff Girl.
Well, I'll take a swap with that over getting buggered by a kraken any day.
I have the letter from Craggle in my pocket. Perhaps one of the runners would like to get the letter out of my left pocket. Not
may
the
right I tie
one,
you?
The left one. Brilliant, wonderful.
Say, oh, this is make good TV. What have you got? You got a love letter for her?
We do. Where's the show's producer?
That's me actually running around to do. So I'm really the only person. I'm an octopus. Lots of hands to do lots of things.
Brilliant, wonderful. We think we have the perfect suitor for the queen. If you will allow me back to the mainland, I can go and get them.
Who is the perfect suitor?
There's a man called Craggle. Here is a letter.
So a lighthouse keeper, I think.
Oh no, he's not. Good suitor for
read this rather three letter.
They've been together for a long time.
Yeah, I know and actually it's just a fuck buddy situation. If I'm honest. Anyway, I think Sheila, she calls over and then the big screen comes down and you see the crack in front of you. You don't like Old Man Crackle, do you? And she sort of makes noises, but it's he can understand. And no, she's not a big fan. And then she starts making more noises, and he's like, "Oh, what? There is somebody. Oh, is that? Anyway, I've got this letter." And then she looks at it, and she's like, angry. And then she conveys for a series of noises back to him that she wanted to help finding someone. She knows who, but he's sort of he's gone missing. And he's she asks if you can help her find him.
You're learning to you want the postman. You want to be romantically involved with the postman.
She
was physically involved with.
She draws a picture for you, and it's a big beast made of plants.
Big beast made of plants.
That would be the thing that Willy's going to go and chop into tiny bits of mulch.
Oh dear.
Based on the descriptions that Jobsworth, the goblin mayor who's exploiting an entire species, is doing.
She says it's called the Guardian.
Guardian.
Right. Well.
Right. Well. I mean, perhaps we could we could help set this up if you could maybe release us from this from underwater so we could go and get this guardian for you.
Yeah,
maybe
she releases you, and we cut to Willy at the beach waiting.
I'm gonna kill a leaf monster.
This is gonna go so badly.
Okay, so currently I'm holding my regulation axe and my big axe. I'm like, I may as well use both. My dominant hand has my big axe. And I'm just, I've got Rob with me still. I've kept Rob with me. Because, you know, he might be handy.
Human shield.
He's agile.
Make a good distraction.
And I'm just what's your plan?
My plan is to wait for it to come and hit it with a big axe.
Okay.
I'm not really a planner.
Okay, so now I'm going to cut back to you two. Oh, who's going to get here first? Who's going to get here first?
Are we able to?
To be sure.
What was the? Have we been dumped back on land or?
No, she's like carrying you through the sea.
She's carrying. She's with us. Yeah.
Yeah.
So we're racing with the Kraken. All right, we need to head to the goblin.
Okay, so what I want, I use four rolls in total. Agility. Okay, let me think. Okay, I'm gonna. Can you two? Okay, I know what I'm gonna do. Okay, we're gonna go back to. We're gonna go back to Willy. Okay, so Willy. You hear a noise, you hear a scuffling of leaves, and the scuffling of leaves keeps coming and coming. There's more rustling, a big rustle sound comes towards you. And finally you see a big fire beast in front of you, about 10 foot tall. When you look into its eyes, you don't see a scary monster. Feel this is a scary monster.
What do I see?
You don't see a scary monster. You feel that he's quite kind. You get a nice feeling from this monster.
Oh, this isn't a level of complexity that I like. I'm going to be like... I'm just going to be like, wait! I'm shouting it. I'm trying to get it to stop. Because I was braced to kind of just charge as soon as I saw it. But like as you said, like if that's the sense I get from it, then I'm gonna like shout for it to stop.
It doesn't stop. Doesn't stop. It just starts smashing up all the industries.
I'm gonna drop my regulation axe, and then I'm gonna basically I want to like kind of if it's gone past me, I want to sort of jump up and like use the handle of my big axe to try and like bring it down like by the neck. So I'm not going to hack at it, but I want to try and like restrain it.
Okay, so if you can roll a
figure out how to do this now. 13.
Oh, okay, you do that successfully. So it's down. Now I'm going to go back to you two. Now, what I want you two to roll for is agility to see how quickly you get.
Which was agility in this, Brawn?
Flight.
Flight.
That is
flight,
my worst stat.
I'm okay.
Oh, wait, no, it's not. It's
9.
Third worst stat.
9 out of 10 for me.
7 out of 8.
7.
Okay, can you... Willy, roll flight twice?
Hmm?
Can you roll flight twice? It's on the sort of...
Alright.
You've got it down.
4 and a 9.
Okay, so you can see them... You can see a monster slowly coming... in the horizon, Willie, and you get a bad feeling from this monster. It's coming at you. You've got the leaf monster on the floor, the guardian on the floor. What do you do now?
Where's this other monster coming from?
It's coming in the sea. See, you can see it coming.
All right. I'm going to shout to the monster that I've got down. And I'm going to be like, do you know what that is? And I'm going to sort of gesture to the, while still trying to hold him that, to the big one coming.
It sort of nods, but whilst it's nodding, you hear rustling in the bushes and some goblins come out and they pin the monster down. Like a Gulliver's Travels kind of situation.
Bad tasting little fuckers.
God damn it. So now I'm going to have to fight goblins as well. I'm going to yell at them to back off.
They did back off.
I'm going to threaten them with my big axe.
The job's
I've got goblins, I've got another monster coming. I've got... My attention's a bit split here. So what are you saying I've talked to?
Jobsworth comes out and he's like, well done. Well done, Willie. Well done, William. We should take it from here. No, you didn't use your regulation axe, I saw.
I've got my regulation axe.
I saw you not use it. But yeah, we'll take it from here. We'll see you later then. Your oath is finished.
No, I don't think you will be taking it from here. I want to know a bit more about what's going on here.
Just a monster situation. You're a monster hunter. This is a monster that needs to be hunted.
This does it, though. This doesn't seem... Why is it attacking your what is it? It was like a generator. Why is it attacking that? Like, what's going on here? When did this start?
Oh, it hates industry. The worst type of monster. A monster that hates industry.
You know what? I think you might have other issues anyway. I'm going to like point to the... What's happening with the other monster, by the way?
So that's slowly getting closer. It's getting bigger and bigger. I'm going to cut to you two. Okay, so you're getting close to land now. What do you do?
And I, because we can see this monster's been pinned down, and I think we need to speed this kraken up. So can I, with my powers of the biblicalness, Jonah and the whale it and climb inside its mouth to make it go faster? I want to climb into. I want to climb into the belly of the kraken, like Jonah and the whale, and you know, essentially put the pedal to the metal. To speed the kraken further along.
You're going
to
climb into the belly of a kraken?
Just like Jonah and the whale, it's a bit biblical thing, that's my specialty. By being inside it, I assume it will be kind of like a mech inside, where I can then pedal to the metal it and make it go quicker.
By what? Kicking its heart a bit more?
Yeah, I get in there, put my foot down and make it go quick.
Are you fed up with this character?
No.
Because I feel you might die. I feel you might die if you do that.
Fine,
if
won't.
If I said a kraken eats you, you'll be like, oh, I'm dead.
No, I climbed into his belly. Jonah and the whale. He comes out of that thing, I think. I don't
I'm not going to stop you, but
I
you might die.
I think he literally... I'm going to look this up.
Are you using any
magic? If I can't use... Yeah, I'm using my God... my Bible powers to Jonah and the whale.
That's not a Bible story, though, is it?
Yeah. Jonah and the Whale's a Bible story.
Is it a Bible story?
Yeah, it's like Old Testament.
So,
Old Testament, not new, but...
Jonah gets swallowed by the whale. He doesn't climb into the whale's nut mouth. He spends 3 days in the whale's stomachs praying for God for forgiveness after he ballses it up.
But I'm sure he doesn't climb into the whale and put the pedal to the metal. I'm taking a little bit of artistic liberty with it.
Then basically tells the whale to release Jonah which he does. So
I could make the Kraken go faster, but if you're saying that's not a thing I'm going to be able to do, then I'm not going to try it.
Well, you can try it. I'm not telling you anything.
Like you could try it with... Yeah, I feel like that's a magical thing you might be able to try.
Do I need to make it go faster? I was just trying to get a bit of a speed boost on. That's all
do it and roll for it. We can find out. I'm just saying I
don't care if there's monster dice. Fuck it. No, it's fine. Going back to my cynical ways of I don't care about this monster. And it's love story. I just wanted to get it there quicker. I was rushing it to the altar, but no, I'll stay on top of it and roll the dice as normal.
Okay, so you're nearly at land anyway, so you can jump off.
Yeah, fine. I get rare opportunities to use Jonah and the whale as a reference point. I just, you know, just a. It's fine.
I like 13.
Oh, you could have done it. I wasn't stopping you. I was confused to how it, because its body isn't a mech,
there would be like something I could kick in there to make it quicken up. Like
you said that your tentacle god could have done it, I would have been like, yeah, no, okay, you've given me a thing of how you'd do that. Just gonna kick its heart,
Bible powers.
Which I think you'll be in the stomach. I think
I didn't say kick its heart, get inside it like Jonah and the whale and make it go quicker. Just there doesn't need to be a, like, I didn't want to have to describe a scientific way of making it happen, because that'd be nonsense. It's fine, I'm not jumping into the Kraken's stomach.
You just needed to be, like, slight magic bullshit, and I'll be like, okay.
I said Bible shit, that's my whole thing.
That's not enough, you need to just go, yeah, a little hint of, like, you know, my tentacle god comes in.
I feel like Bible covers that, like, my speciality being Bible stuff.
You needed to describe how your Bible stuff would work, not just go, the Bible.
Well, I don't know how magic works, do I? I can't describe how my Bible stuff works, it's just Bible stuff, by Jonah and the Whaling it. That was the gist.
Divine intervention.
Yeah, through Jonah and the Whale again.
Oh, do you want to do it? I don't want to stop. I don't want to stop you from doing what you want to do.
No.
I'm not stopping you. I just want to.
If the risk of. I don't want my character to die based on just trying to.
He might not die. We're doing it. Thematically. We'll find out who's right.
We're good. We're just playing with some theme in. It's fine.
Because, I mean, yeah, it's like 50-50 whether you do really well or die. Cause,
yeah, so that's not worth it, really. Just for a bit of theming. I'm not. We'll carry on. We'll not go in the way.
You're at land. The monster's tied down. What do you do?
I assume the Kraken's going to do a lot of the heavy lifting here in terms of killing off goblins.
The goblins are jumping at the Kraken.
Is Dole Jobsworth within, like, if I were to do the whole vampire mental domination-y thing?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you want to.
Cool to just kind of, like, you know, do that.
You roll for it. That'd be a magic roll, which is flight. Is it flight? No, fight. It'd be fight. Yeah, do a magic roll. Yeah. 17, yes.
Wonderful. Can I get Jobsworth to slit his own throat?
Yeah,
Jesus Christ.
I thought you were going to get him to command them to stop.
Yes, yeah, same.
He really tries to sort of stop himself from doing it. He's like,
I'm just stood just there like that with my hands
over.
Look at the rest of the goblins, and I'm like, do you want to follow him?
And they all scarper off.
Yeah, damn fucking right they do.
Well, that was easy.
Now you've.
I'm kind of like looking at these two and the Kraken and being like, so you guys are back. I think maybe I'm not supposed to kill this thing.
I think this thing just wants love. Or if it doesn't, it's unfortunate because we've brought a Kraken who really wants love.
We've brought a really powerful beast to, you know, the shore, so either they're going to get it on or the town's gone completely.
And we need to run.
All right.
Frankly, regardless of what happens, we should probably get out of here real quick. Things are going to get very tense, clear. but yeah, we want to knock out all the little, you know, Gulliver's Travels things that are holding it to the ground. Just
let's free this creature and then.
Yeah, so you free him. The Kraken moves its head to the end of water, and then the other one, they look at each other, and then they kiss, and then they go back their own ways.
Aww.
That's what they do. Cute. Go their own ways, okay. Not much of a day.
They can't live in each other's things. They're just sort of...
Oh, okay, yeah.
So... Oh, it's like a tragic... Yeah. Oh, well.
Almost didn't feel worth it.
Yeah, really.
I was expecting one of them to die, to be honest. I was expecting that was all the
time. I mean, someone died. Goblin made
it. Yeah, a power vacuum now in Goblin Man. That's interesting.
The thing is, like, you made it very clear to my character that this monster wasn't evil.
Yeah.
Whereas,
I thought it was necessary.
If you held on to that, I might have tried to kill it.
I thought it was necessary. It's not because it's like a guardian, like you wouldn't feel a bad feeling towards it. Like it's not like a. But there's a power vacuum down Goblin built to figure out later on.
Yeah, so. I don't feel very good about all this industrial stuff. I feel like.
I think Goblin Town needs to have someone in charge that can stop the industry.
Yeah. We're not discussing putting Rob Goblin back in charge of Goblin Town.
He didn't like it. He very much didn't like the industrial stuff. So he might be the guy. But
he is Rob Goblin and he is a pile of problems.
Yeah, he's a bit of a bad bloke, really.
Would be now your hair, I guess.
But you would then have no staff Woolworths.
Oh, shit, yeah.
But quite frankly, having no one staff in Woolworths might be better than having Rob Goblin staff in Woolworths.
I do have
There's some that too.
I mean, stable hands that can help out in Woolworths.
Yeah. I mean, stable hands, yeah. Yeah,
You see the Hessman come off of she come around the corner. He's like, ah, what a great adventure we've all had.
Oh, damn it, he came back.
I was on the cracking, weren't I?
Yeah, but I assumed, you know, whatever happens, like, I don't know, I assumed, hopes that maybe it was just these two that came back, but.
It's me as well. Yes, I heard you want leader for Goblin, Phil.
And, hey, Rob, I think you're the guy.
Well, I'm going to put my application in for Woolies then.
I mean,
you've got a job. You're on like you run a tourist.
Yeah,
thing.
You've got your whole thing going on. You'll be overworked.
Fairies, man.
I've got a lot going on. I can do a lot. I don't really sleep. I'm like a fish.
I mean, if you want a job that badly, there's a field with corn that's currently unguarded, and there's a large piece of wood that we.
Well, I can't really do that. Since I can't get back into the straw realm, I can't really do that kind of thing anymore.
I mean, my fields. You can scare away the tourists by chatting shit.
Nah. I'll carry on working for everything, I reckon.
Bastard.
And Hessian tours. Yeah, we haven't fixed the fairy problem or the pirate goblins.
Well, I feel like the fairy problem was the Kraken problem, right?
Yeah.
There's a distressed Kraken that was... I kind of forgot about the fairies, but but yes. I think that is what it is. Was there...
In which case, Hessian Tours is back on, so you're going to be very busy, Hessian man. We probably won't see you at the council anymore. You just run off your feet.
Yeah, that sounds good. The shame about Rob Goblin, he's going to have to be doing the mayor thing. It sounds like a bad job.
You're right, that is a shame.
Hey, Crinkle Crinkle
might want to do that. No, Crinkle, because that leaves a... You're not being mayor of anywhere, Hessian man. Like, we're not letting you be mayor. Like, stop it.
You're not allowed power.
He was mayor of Goblinville before and everything was all good.
Yeah, and now he's mayor of, like, the rest. So, like, we kind of need him there.
Oh, well.
We're not creating another power vacuum. We're not doing it.
We've already got one of those today.
Yeah.
If Rob turns to you, he's like, oh, see, I don't know if I could be mayor.
God,
Rob?
No one's going to listen to me. Imagine me just walking in this, but hey, God, no, listen to me.
Yeah, you've done that before.
Yeah, it's all different now, though. I'm a city boy.
I'm not normally a proponent of such things, but have we considered democracy? Shouldn't the goblins vote on their mayor?
Democracy doesn't work, you know that.
What's that?
Democracy doesn't work, you know that. That's how you end up that with, that whole thing. What was it? The election yards. That was a nightmare.
Well, you're not wrong, but
I think it was rigged by you, actually, wasn't it? Isn't it slightly rigged by you? Essie Man won that, technically.
Yeah, a lot happened. There were clones. There were bees.
Man was just a cloud of bees, and he did a pretty good job of things, I think.
Well, he had, you know, previous experience.
Is there a way out of the situation where Hessian Man doesn't become the mayor of Goblin Town?
The thing is, he really wants Hessian Man to be a mayor of something, I think. But I don't want that to happen.
I mean, we could just leave it mayor. Power vacuums can work sometimes. Maybe they'll work themselves into the commune. You know?
Well, until NATO hear about it.
We could.
I think election might be a good idea, huh?
Well, I was just thinking we could if Rob Goblin's a little bit worried about running the place and being the face of it. Why don't we just take the skin from Jobsworth's face and put it on Rob Goblin like a mask?
Not doing face off.
We're on my home, Al.
My grandfather, you know, did something, he heard of something similar in our hometown just before we moved over to this wonderful little island community where someone was in charge and they died under very suspicious circumstances and they needed a very quick replacement. So that's when my great-great-great-great-great-grandfather came up with the idea of, or rather heard of, the idea of putting someone's face over your own and pretending to be them.
I will say this, it's Christmas next month, and we're probably too busy with that to worry about the goblins, so I can just let go. That's what I reckon.
Sounds good to me. The less I have to think about goblins, the better.
What do you think, Willie?
Yeah, I feel like, obviously, from... Yeah, you know what? I'm kind of sick of dealing with it. I think maybe we should suggest to them that they have an election, maybe hold like an emergency council meeting where we discuss the... I mean, Crinkle Crunkle can handle this. He's a good ambassador. He can sort out, you know, an election process, and also maybe avoid guardian spirits destroying the town in the future. What, you know, and then leave it at that. I feel like that's our job done, man.
Yeah, I leave it to him. That'd be leave fun. It to,
yeah. He's a good goblin. So, yeah, right. I think that's
job well
wrapped
done.
Up.
So I sorted
another successful council meeting.
Yeah.
With zero consequences for long-term storytelling.
Someone needs to break it to old man Craggle that he's lost his toy.
I'm going to have to do that. I've got to go and sing at some point.
No, it's fine. I'm the priest. I like bringing bad news to people.
We did manage to avoid Craggle. That's pretty... That is job well done, actually.
Do you guys not like him?
I love... Well, no. I mean, it's just... It makes you feel uncomfortable hearing about a man being used like a fleshlight by a kraken, so it's just...
Although
just to avoid the uncomfortableness.
Actually, we now know why. It's because the kraken's just like, well, I can't see my guardian spirit boyfriend that regularly because we're literally in different worlds, so, you know, I need an intermediary in the meantime. Do you want to deal with a sexually frustrated kraken?
I certainly don't.
Exactly.
How did the session went? Any notes?
That's all, folks. So.